Hello, good morning all. Today in this video we are going to discuss about how to create new user groups from the code. So you know we are using the groups for setting the access rights and code rules for the models. So if we activate the developer mode, so for that I will go to the settings and I will activate the developer mode. So once after you activate the developer mode, you will get a menu named groups under the users and companies menu. So if I go to the groups menu, you can see there are around 74 internal groups in the system right now. So, and while we are defining the security rules, if we go to the security here in the, that is, we have two types of security, that is either we can add the security by record rules or access rights. You can see if I open the access rights, you can see we are giving the security based on the groups. You can see access groups in access right. As well as if you go to the record rules, and if I open the record rules, so this is the record rules, and if I open the record rules, you can see here also we are giving the record rules based on the group. So let's see how we can create the group from the code. So if I go to the PyCharm and we are continuing the development with the hospital management system, and our module is OM underscore hospital. And I have already told in one of my previous video that we will place all the security related files inside the security folder. So for that purpose, I have already created a XML file, that is security.xml. So you can name the file as per your need. So either you can give patient security or hospital security.xml. So the name can be anything. So inside this XML file, we will define the group. So I have already called this new file, that is security/security.xml. File is called inside the manifest file. So let's see how we can create the group from the code. So here I have added the basic syntax for when you create a file, that is XML version 1 encoding UTF-8, and inside the odo tag I have already added a new record, that is record with ID group hospital doctor, and model you have to give inside which model the record has to be created, that is restored groups, and given the name for the groups as doctor. So this is how simple we can create a new group, that is you have to give an ID for the record and the model has to be restored groups, and you can give a name. Suppose if we need to create another group for the manager, just copy the same and I will paste the same under this, and I will correct the indentations. So this corrected the indentation, and I have to change the ID of the record. So here right now we have the ID group hospital doctor, then instead of doctor I will change the ID to the name, ID to the manager. So the ID of the doctor group is group hospital doctor, and the ID of the manager, I'll just rename this group, that is I rename to the manager, and the ID is group hospital manager. So just we have created two new user groups, that is one for doctor and the other for manager. So let's upgrade the module and see what we get. So we have created an security.xml file, and inside that we have defined two user groups, and we have called the same file inside the manifest file. So now I will restart the service, and service is restarted. Now I'll go to the front end. Yes, from here, from the apps menu, I'll upgrade the module. So before upgrading the module, I will show you. It's getting loading. Okay, so before upgrading the module, I will go to the settings again, and inside the groups, if I search for the group doctor, so if I search for the group doctor D-O-C-T-O-R, you can see there is no group with the name doctor. So let's upgrade the module and see what we get out of it. So from here I will upgrade the module. So once after the module is upgraded, let's see what we get after we go to the groups menu. So the module keeps loading. Okay, the module get upgraded. So yes, let's go to the hospital settings menu. And if I go to the hospital menu, sorry, if I go to the groups menu, and if I search for the doctor, you can see a new group get created, that is a group with a given name has created. And if I search for the name manager, there is a lot of manager group, but you can see the manager, that is because this is the manager group we have created. So if I ask, developer mode is activated, if I click on here view metadata, if I click on view metadata, you can see this is the XML ID, that is OM hospital is our module, group hospital manager, that is the ID we have given here, that is group hospital manager. And if I search for doctor again, if I come back here and search for doctor, you can see the XML ID from view metadata, that is OM hospital dot, that is module name dot group hospital doctor, that is group hospital doctor. So this is how you can just simply create a new user groups in Odoo. So if I go to the users form view, so you will assign the groups to users from the users form view. And if I open an existing user, that is Mark demo, you can see the newly added groups comes under the other option, that is you can see doctor as well as manager groups comes under the other option. But you can see here there is extra rights, accounting and finance group category. Here you have technical settings like that. Let's see how we can create a new category for hospital, and under that how the doctor and manager can bring. So for defining new category, I will just make search of search inside the existing codes. So if I click on Ctrl Shift F and search inside the existing codes, you can see a sample category here. So I will again search that, and let's see how it is created. So if I search for ID equal to that given category, you can get the sample code here. I will just copy that and I will paste it inside our file. That is, I will just adjust the indentations here. Okay, and this is model is ir.moduleCategory, and you have to give an ID for the record, that is module category hospital. Just give a category name standing with the subject. So I have updated the ID as module category hospital, and name has to be given this hospital. This hospital will comes like this, accounting and finance, like extra rights, like that we need hospital or hospital management. Like that we can give a name, and you can give it the sample description regarding the user category. So I'll just remove the things there, and I'll just discard the category for hospital. Like that I will give a sample description there. It's not mandatory. If you need, don't need, you can avoid category for hospital. Okay, I'll just remove the sequence code right now, and I will explain it later. So we have added a new category, that is we have created a new record in ir.module.category with the name hospital management and description as category for hospital. Now I will upgrade the module. As we have made changes inside the XML, there is no need to restart the service again. So I will go to the apps menu and I will upgrade the module. So once after the module is upgraded, I will show you the use of the module category. Okay, the module is still loading. Okay, I think the module is loaded successfully. So once the loading is completed, we will go to the settings, and from here we can take the groups. And if I search for the doctor group, from here I can search the doctor DOC. I can get a doctor group here, and I will open the doctor group. And inside this application, that is application is the category ID. So here inside the application, if I search for hospital, you can see hospital management is coming. That is, this is the newly created category which we have created here from the code. Now let's see how we can assign this category to the user group. So here you can see by default, when we selecting the doctor, the application is not coming. That is, hospital management is not coming here from the code. So for that, what we have to do is that, so if I again make a search inside the existing code, that is Ctrl Shift F in PyCharm, you can see the category ID is giving like this. So I will copy that code and I will paste it inside our module. Here you can see field name is category ID, and here you have to give the ID of the category. So this is the ID of the category we have created. I've just copied this ID and I will put it here. That is, then the doctor group will comes under this category. So I will copy the same line and put it for the manager group also. I'll just correct the indentations. Okay, right now you can see by default the application is not coming. So let's upgrade the module. So for that, I'll go to the apps menu and I will upgrade the module again. Here you can see what we have made the changes is, we have created a new category, that is hospital management, and specified that record here as category ID. So I think the module is getting still it's getting upgrading. So let's wait. Okay, the module get upgraded successfully. Now we will go to the settings and then to the groups menu, and if I make search of doctor, you can see the name itself will come in another format, that is it will come as hospital management slash doctor. Yes, you can see once we search the doctor, you can see the group name is coming hospital management bar doctor, that is application name bar group name. And if I open the doctor record, you can see application get set from the code. And if I search for the manager group, manager here, you can see hospital management slash manager. You can search here with the category also. If I search for hospital here, you can see under the hospital there is two user groups, that is doctor as well as manager. And if I go to the users form view, earlier when we have checked the users form view, we have seen the two groups, that is doctor and manager, comes under the other category. But right now, as we have given category for those, if I click on edit and scroll the screen down, you can see the new category comes here, that is hospital management with doctor as well as the manager. So this is how you can create a category. You can see here this category accounting finance is same as the hospital management, but let's see how these things are coming here. Like if I click on edit button, you can see the groups under sales, that is sales application, the groups are listed like this, like a selection field. Now let's see how we can make our hospital management to comes on here and list the groups like this. For this, what you have to do is that implied IDs has to be given for the groups. So if I search the restricted groups again, Ctrl Shift F, you can see an implied ID is coming here. Okay, I will copy the implied IDs and I will add it here. I will explain the criteria. I'll just make the correct indentations. And inside the implied IDs, I will copy the ID of this record. I'll just copy this and I will paste the inside that record, that ID here in the implied IDs. So in the implied IDs of the manager group, I have given the ID of the doctor. That is, we are creating an hierarchy, that is manager will comes at the top and then under the manager, the doctor will come. So that if we set an access right for the doctor, the same access rights will be available for the doctor also. That is because see here, manager is at the top position and the doctor is coming under the manager. So if we set any access rules for the doctor, the same access rights and record rules will be available for the higher level authority. So here we have specified imperatives, that is doctor is coming under the manager, like that we have given implied IDs here. So I will upgrade the module once again. So you can see before upgrading the module, you can see hospital management is coming here. So if I go to the apps menu and if I upgrade the module, so from the apps menu, I will upgrade the module again. Okay, the module is getting loaded. So once after the module get loaded, we can see the change. Okay, the module is still loading. Loading. If I go to the users form view, there is an error. I think there is some other error. Let's remove it. If I go to the settings and if I go to the users form view again, and if I open an existing users form view, okay, if I scroll down, you can see the hospital management comes here. So when we have checked earlier, it was coming here, but right now it has comes here at the top. So from here, this selection, you can choose whether it is doctor or whether it is manager. So by giving implied IDs, you will get like this. So you can see right now the hospital management is coming at the right top of this screen. If you need to come in between some another, like if you have to come under the pouches, can adjust it with the sequence. So here is the category. So here I can give a field sequence. So here for give sequence, I will give the sequence as a higher number. So let me give the sequence as 45. And if I upgrade the module, lower the sequence, the application will be listed at the top. So I have given the hospital management sequence as 45, which is a higher value. So definitely our hospital management will goes down of the screen. So I will upgrade the module once again. So right now we are seeing the hospital management at the top, but after we give a sequence of 45 and upgrade the module, definitely it will go to the down position. So let's check the same after the upgrading. Okay, the module is upgraded successfully, but it's still loading. I will go to the hospital menu settings, and from here if I go to the users form view, it's loading. And if I open the Mark demo record, and if you check for the hospital management, yeah, it's not at the top. And if I scroll down, you can see it's coming here. That's we have given a higher sequence. So higher the sequence, the group will go down. So this is all about how to create new user groups in Odoo. If you have any queries regarding this, you can comment it out, or you can reach us over the mail. The email ID is odoomates@gmail.com. Feel free to contact us. Thank you.